Welcome everyone. My name is Adrian Spurr. I'm a PhD student at the AIT lab at ETH Zurich. Today, I'll be presenting together with Aneesh Dahiya our research on PeCLR, a self-supervised 3D hand pose estimation method using contrastive learning. As the title suggests, the task addressed by this project is 3D hand pose estimation. Simply stated, given a monocular RGB image, we would like to regress the full 3D hand pose using neural networks. This is the rapidly growing area which has been addressed in various forms by prior work. These works can be categorized based on the type of data annotation they investigate. Under such a view, one can obtain the following categories. We have the fully supervised methods which make use of full 3D annotation. Such methods lead to high performance on target datasets, but do not generalize well to in-the-wild imagery. Weakly supervised methods make use of additional weaker annotations, such as 2D or noisy labels. Such methods can generalize better to in-the-wild settings, but are bounded by the performance of the automatic or human annotator. Lastly, we have the semi-supervised methods that can utilize unlabeled image samples. Yet, these are limited by restrictions, such as requiring partially labeled videos. In our work, we focus on the semi-supervised setting and aim to leverage unlabeled data without any limitation. Specifically, we observe that there is an opportunity for utilizing vast amount of in-the-wild data which do not contain lab-annotated 2D or 3D labels. But how can we utilize such data in an efficient manner without requiring specialized architectures or restrictions? To this end, we introduce PeCLR, short for Pose-Equivariant Contrastive Learning. It is an approach that leverages unlabeled in-the-wild data and is capable of outperforming specialized neural network architectures using a standard ResNet model. Let us see how this is done by first taking a look at the contrastive learning literature. Contrastive approaches have been gaining traction in the area of self-supervision. They have shown promising results as a pre-training step on large amount of data. Simply stated, the main principle behind them is as follows. Given positive and negative pairs of images, the network is trained to increase a score for the positive samples, while at the same time decreasing it for the negatives. The trained network can then be fine-tuned on labeled task-specific data, which lead to increased performance for the task at hand. Out of these works, we base our method on SimClear. Positive pairs of images are created by applying image transformation to a source image. Given the positive pair, here shown in green, we want to increase the score of the normalized latent representation. At the same time, we decrease the score for the negative samples, shown in red. Here the negative samples consist of augmented samples of other images. As no labeled information is needed to train under such a scenario, SimClear can be applied to vast amounts of unlabeled data. When fine-tuning for tasks such as classification, SimClear has shown impressive results. However, how do things change when transitioning from classification to pose estimation? Let us take a step back to look at the bigger picture. In tasks such as classification, invariance under most image transformation is required. For example, if you rotate this image of a cat, the class of the image will not change, as it still displays a cat. On the other hand, in pose estimation we require equivariance under affine transformations. So in our previous example of rotation, if you rotate the hand, the pose changes accordingly. Let us return to the contrastive framework, this time considering the task of hand pose estimation. As before, we generate positive and negative image pairs. But to maximize agreement under all transformations, SimClear induces invariance. Yet as motivated before, we desire for pose estimation to be equivariant under affine transformations. To address this, we need to consider these transformations explicitly during the loss function calculation. To this end, we propose to undo the affine transformations in latent space and encourage maximal agreement between the untransformed latent samples. This inversion of transformation forces the model to project its latent samples in accordance to the affine transformation. This in turn leads to the desired property of equivariance. We call the resulting equivariant contrastive framework Pose-Equivariant Contrastive Learning, or PeCLR for short. In summary, the proposed model functions as follows. Given a set of images, we apply a random set of appearance and geometric transformations. We feed these through a network and a projection layer, and obtain a latent representation. We undo the affine transformation in latent space to then obtain the latent samples of an untransformed image. We then encourage the normalized representation of positive pairs to lie close to each other, whereas normalized negative pairs should repel each other. Next, Aneesh will be talking about the reevaluation of the proposed framework.
Thanks, Adrian. We focus on the question of how pre-training on unlabeled data using PeCLR will affect performance. More specifically, we break this question down into two main components. First, how does it affect performance on a target dataset? And second, how does it affect generalizability? Here, the labeled and target dataset is FreiHAND, a fully labeled dataset which is shown on the left. The unlabeled dataset consists of YouTube 3D hands, which is shown on the right. We note that this dataset contains automatically annotated labels obtained via OpenPose and ManoFitting, which we will use for the evaluation of the cross-dataset setting. During all experiments, the two-stage settings is as follows. We first pre-train a network self-supervised on unlabeled data using the proposed PeCLR loss. In the second stage, we fine-tune the pre-trained model on the downstream task of hand pose estimation. This is done with the help of labeled data. There are two ways we perform fine-tuning, following similar schemes as proposed in the related work. In the first, we freeze the encoder and train an MLP on labeled data using the encoder's feature representation. This is done to evaluate transformations and to derive the best performing set of augmentations for pre-training for hand pose. In the second fine-tuning variant, we fine-tune the entire model on labeled data. This is done to assess the final performance of the model. We consider a variety of transformations, both appearance-based, here shown by the green text, as well as affine transformations, shown in blue text. Note that it is for these affine transformations we compute our equivariant contrastive loss. As the latent vectors are normalized, undoing the scaling in latent space will have no effect. Hence, our loss formulation addresses the rotation and translation transformations. Let us take a closer look at how these are affected by evaluating the resulting feature representation using either SimCLR or PeCLR. We pre-train a ResNet 50 for each augmentation using either framework and evaluate its performance by training an MLP on the resulting feature representation. The performance is quantified as a 3D endpoint error on FreiHAND. We observe that for both translation and rotation, PeCLR clearly outperforms SimCLR. This indicates that equivariant contrastive loss formulation is more aligned with the pose estimation task. Next, we identify the optimal performing augmentation schemes for both SimCLR and PeCLR using exhaustive search. We pre-train both models using the respective optimal augmentation strategies and evaluate the resulting feature representation as before. We see that PeCLR outperforms SimCLR by a clear margin. However, does the equivariance property hold after fine-tuning? To see this, we inspect the PeCLR and SimCLR to measure the amount of equivariance. This is done after fine-tuning the entire model. To this end, we rotate the input image and inspect the resulting predictions of PeCLR and SimCLR. Here, we show the qualitative results. To the left, we see the pose estimation by SimCLR, and to the right, we see the pose estimation by PeCLR. The pose estimate from PeCLR is much stable when compared with that of SimCLR. This can also be observed quantitatively. Here, the y-axis shows the percentage of improvement in equivariance of PeCLR over SimCLR, whereas the x-axis denotes the rotation degrees. We test both for FreiHAND as well as for YouTube 3D hands. We observe that both datasets, PeCLR leads to a more improved equivariant representation after fine-tuning. Having identified the optimal augmentation strategy and contrastive framework, we move on to comparison with the state-of-the-art. For this task, we train four models. We train a ResNet 50 and a ResNet 152 from scratch, as well as from pre-trained weights using PeCLR. We see that training a model from scratch is not sufficient to surpass the state of the art. Here, ResNet 152 reaches parity, but uses more model capacity than I2L meshnet. However, the situation changes when considering PeCLR. When fine-tuning on a pre-trained PeCLR model, we observe a notable decrease in error, where both ResNets outperform the state of the art. Lastly, we look at if this increase in performance also carries across datasets. We take the best performing model of the previous experiment and run it on our YouTube 3D hands. We observe that PeCLR leads to improved performance, most notably in 2D pixel error. This indicates that the improvement brought by PeCLR generalizes across dataset. In conclusion, we would like to emphasize two main take-home points. First, we have provided empirical evidence that pre-training on large, unlabeled dataset holds potential for improving performance of hand pose estimators, even across datasets. We demonstrate this by training a standard network which is capable of outperforming specialized, state-of-the-art architectures. Second, the equivariance property induced during pre-training holds after fine-tuning. This is exciting, as you could attempt to induce other properties such as smoothness across video frames or robustness to noise. For code, more results, and information, we encourage you to check our paper and website. Thank you.